Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the film Angry Birds. Take a look at this. I don't even know how we can get any work done here. You know, the movie takes place on an island paradise, so it only made sense that Sony would send all the journalists here to Maui to sit down with the cast. And we had a chance to talk with Jason Sudeikis, Josh Gad, and funny lady Maya Rudolph.
Hey, Red, how are you?
Oh, I'm horrible.
Mr. Red? There seems to be a recurring issue here. Anger.
Explain to my bosses why we're here in Maui.
Yeah.
We're here because we all felt like accountant. We deserved a vacation.
Yeah.
Honestly, I mean, we were like, and Jason and I spoke about it.
Yeah. We had to okay with them. And
we
they
sat
were
down,
all
we talked
like,
to them.
Yeah, and they were like, okay, fine, just leave us alone.
You really respect her, and like, that's yep. great.
We put some words in their mouth, and we forged some documents, and we got right. you here. So you're welcome.
Thank you. And
we're welcome as well, because right. we had to talk people into letting us get here, too.
We got a lot of people watching a movie now at Harkins Theater, and they think this is work. How do you guys get work done when you're in a setting like this?
I mean, you have people sit you down and put a mic on you, and the next thing you know, you're working.
Yeah.
There's a whole montage of what happens to his body during yes. the anger process.
Yes.
What happens to your bodies when the blood starts to boil?
My body gets a little more bloated, if you could imagine that, yeah. I retain a lot of water and tension the angrier I get.
I feel like I grit my teeth. Mine starts in the jaw. And I feel like I can picture my father when it getting angry. I think that's where I get it from.
Usually a lot of steam coming out of my ears, just pure steam. Like, then you hear, like, the whistle from a boat. I don't know, because I don't know about you, but I feel like you're it's almost out of body when you get mad, because it's always embarrassing later. Like, once you've cooled down, you're like, that was ridiculous. I acted like a jerk, you know? I feel like while it's happening and it's kind of slow motion, like, you're not really aware of how ridiculous you're being. But you kind of feel like a toddler, like having like a tantrum.
I carry my tension here when I'm angry.
In your forearms?
Like in my arms, and just like, or I'll tense my fists up in the moment, so I don't know what could go wrong.
Yeah, just like fire shoots out of your palms.
What if I'm Magneto? Yeah. What if I can control
what
metal?
If?
That know, would be like, cool though, if
yeah,
that were
but
the
it
case.
Could also be devastating, because I don't know
That's
how to
true.
Control my powers.
It is, it's a
like James McAvoy.
You don't strike me as somebody who gets angry often.
I love you. I love you for saying that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're a good actress then, I guess.
I'm clearly an award-winning actress.
Yeah.
Not often, but I'm more than capable of getting hot-headed. Absolutely. I feel like, honestly, in my recent adult years, I'm getting a little bit better at it. I'm trying, and I think it's being mindful because of children, because you can't be a hypocrite and say, like, don't get so frustrated, try not to get angry, because kids get mad like that, and then they're over it like that. And it's helpful to see in your kids, and also you have to lead by example. So it makes you fess up a lot.
Welcome to the Infinity Acceptance Group. I am Matilda.
Matilda is in charge of teaching this anger management class. What sort of course would you actually be really good at teaching?
Ooh, that's a good question. Course in how to play Connect Four. I'm very good at it. I never lose.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is. I'm unstoppable. And it really makes people angry when they don't win, because it's so simple.
Yeah.
It's so much fun to beat people at it.
We're gonna be working on managing our anger through movement.
Eagle, heron, peacock, warrior, mountain, tree, rabbit, fish, locust, king pigeon,
and of course, downward duck.
Ugh. Maya's character has you guys doing yoga.
Yes.
My favorite, paint your pain.
Yeah.
If you were to paint your pain, would it be kind of a Bob Ross landscape, or would it be more of a Jackson Pollock? What would, if you were to paint your pain?
Mine would probably be at like a second grade painting level.
Like a finger painting sort of vibe.
Like it would be finger painting or stick figures who are like sad, like statistic figures.
My pain is very similar to Georgia O'Keeffe. You know, just very...
Sexual in nature, but flowers?
I don't know if the female anatomy is always sexual. I feel it just is what it is.
Like M.C. Escher drawing, just like a Picasso, but like a perfect Picasso.
But something we'd have to kind of peel through the layers to get to?
I feel like Jackson Pollock is a good example, though. Like, just physically getting things out of your body.
Me, I am the last guy who should be here. Simple speeding ticket. Judge tells me I was going too fast, so I say, Your Honor, to be honest, I was.
I get winded just listening to your guy. Like, did it help having like good breath control, like as a singer and stuff like that?
Yeah, you do.
In all seriousness.
In all seriousness, it does, because the speed at which Chuck operates is so much, it's so much faster than I naturally speak at. So by like the third take, I was saying, I'm like, my lips would go numb because I'm just not used to speaking that fast. And yeah. And doing like a single paragraph on one breath is, it's tricky.
It's like, it gives a lot of respect to like Eminem. Like,
yeah.
We're kind of like, breath control. Who'd have thunk?
If anyone knows what these pigs are up to, it's Mighty Eagle.
It's Mighty Eagle's Lake of Wisdom.
Every kid has a Mighty Eagle.
Yeah.
Yes.
Someone they look up to. Who was that Mighty Eagle for you guys?
Mine was Jason Sudeikis from
that?
Saturday Night Live.
I so much younger than me.
Yeah. I don't, this Jason Sudeikis I can live without.
Right.
That one was a thinking man's Sudeikis. Yeah.
Gilda Radner was to me like this shining star in New York City that just, I don't know. I mean, as an adult, when I sort of look back and thought, why was she so appealing? She always had a smile on her face. She looked genuinely happy. That was really infectious to me. She's just so, she felt so easy to love. And she looked like she was having so much fun. And then truly like that original SNL cast. I know it's an obvious answer, but it's
a good answer.
Weirdly true. I used to do impressions of Roseanne Dana when I was little, because I really had that. Hers was a wig, but mine was not.
Yeah. Which is why it was.
Which
so
is
effective.
Why it's in a bun today. Yeah.
We're in Hawaii. Will you please explain to my bosses why it had to happen here?
Because life is better in Hawaii.
See, no one's ever angry.
No one's angry here.
Ever.
I don't see anybody yelling at anybody here. It's perfect. It's actually paradise.
I really could use your hair guy right now.
I know.
Yeah.
Buns all
around. Buns the way to go.
Yeah.
Next time.
I just want to say it was the first interview I've ever done in Tradewinds, and I really enjoy it.
Does it make my hair look ridiculous?
No, you look like Beyonce. Are you kidding me?
I look like a white Beyonce.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Not bad, right?
Doesn't anyone see what's going on here? The whole world is in danger, and it's up to us to stop them.
Fire!
Real!
Oh my God.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Angry Birds. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. I hope you can make it out to Maui sometime. It has really been a lot of fun. And we'll see you at the movies.